published 1952 EDT, the 19th of August 2017 updated 2033 EDT, the 19th of August 2017 Chelsea's controversial farm system of hoarding players means they have an astonishing 62 senior contracted professionals on the books, although their stockpile then sell approach is increasingly profitable. An analysis by the Mail on Sunday shows they have made a profit of £107.6 million in the past 5 years alone from selling 20 farm players. But Chelsea have apparently not made consistently sensible choices in who they sell and who they keep, with current high-value stars including Romelu Lukaku and Kevin De Bruyne among those thriving and worth much more since departing. Romelu Lukaku earned Chelsea an £18 million profit when he moved to Everton in 2014. Chelsea's 62 senior pros are comprised of 25 members of the current first-team squad, 26 players out on loan, 4 in the Premier League, and 11 more in effect waiting to be loaned. On top of the 62, there is a development squad of 25-plus dozens more youngsters in younger pre-professional age groups. Our analysis looked at the 32 players sold for money by Chelsea in the past 5 years. There were 12 regular players, mostly bought over, 21 for the first team and never loaned out, and 20 farm players, mostly acquired as teenagers, who rarely played league games and spent most of the time loaned out. Chelsea lost striker Dominic Solanke to Liverpool for a fee which will be decided at a tribunal. 12 regulars in this analysis were Nemanja Matic, Juan Cuadrado, Asmir Begovic, John Obi Mikel, Oscar Ramirez, Petr Cech, Felipe Luis, Andre Schürrle, Fernando Torres, David Luiz, and Juan Mata. Those regular players were acquired at an average age of 24, for £20.3 million on average, then played an average 113 league games before being sold for £24.1 million on average. The farm players joined Chelsea on average age at 17, for £2.5 million, being sold for an average £7.9 million profit each after just 6 league appearances in as many years. Kevin De Bruyne was sold to Wolfsburg before he joined Manchester City for £54 million. The farm system is seen as controversial for two main reasons. First, that Chelsea are stockpiling players simply because they are rich enough to do so, depriving rivals access to them. And second, that Chelsea exert to whatever small degree a hold on loan clubs. For example, it is normal that Chelsea players never face the parent club as a condition of a loan. As a strategy, it evidently pays financially, most recently evidenced by a £20 million profit on Nathan Ake, who made 7 league appearances in 6 years at Stamford Bridge, mostly away on loan. Mohamed Salah was sold to Roma following a disappointing spell at Stamford Bridge, yet Lukaku, De Bruyne and Mohamed Salah, collectively bought for Chelsea for £28 million, have recently sold for £167 million plus add-ons by the clubs Chelsea sold them to. Chelsea made a £35 million combined profit on the three, but might have made £139 million profit, or indeed kept a trio now making waves elsewhere. Chelsea's opponents on Sunday, Tottenham, take a contrasting approach to player development, developing multiple players for first-team action, where they are thriving. The 20 farm players are detailed in the accompanying green box, in alphabetical order, showing the names, number of Premier League games and profit Chelsea made on each of them, the profit being the difference between the acquisition cost and the sale cost. Total 20 players, 126 appearances, £107.6 million sales profits, not including any loans fees. Average 6.3 apps per player, £5.4 million profit per player. Tribunal TBC estimate Chelsea want £10 million.